नमो नमः। लेट अस लर्न संस्कृत वर्सेस। सुभाषितम नंबर 42। ओंकारश्चाथ शब्दश्च अधियाम सुभाषितानि संस्कृतंश्च। इन सुभाषितम नंबर 41 ओम सहनाववतु। व्हेन एक्सप्लेनिंग व्हाई ओम इज अ सेक्रेट सिलेबल आई कोटेड अ श्लोकः एज बिलो। ओंकारश्चाथ शब्दश्च द्वावेतौ ब्रह्मणः पुरा कंठं भित्वा विनिर्यातौ तस्मान् मांगलिकावुभौ। पदच्छेदैः ओंकारः च अथ शब्दः च द्वौ एतौ ब्रह्मणः पुरा कंठं भित्वा विनिर्यातौ तस्मात् मांगलिकौ उभौ। अन्वयाः शब्दाभ्यासाश्च। I will split this into two parts. First one, Omkarah cha, atha shabdah cha, etau dvau, pura, brahmanah kantham bhitva, vinir yatau. There also, one component, Omkarah cha, atha shabdah cha, etau dvau. This phrase is common kartru vibhagah for both bhitva and vinirjatav. Omkaraha, doing expression of om, cha avyayam, and atha iti shabdaha, atha shabdaha, karmadharaya. Atha avyayam, a particle used at the beginning of works, mostly as a sign of auspiciousness, and translated by here, now, begins. Shabdaha, shabda, word or sound. Pullingam, prathamaikavachanam. Etau, etat, sarvanama, this. Tasya, pullingam, prathamavibhaktihi, dvivachanam. Dvau, dvi, two, sankhyavisheshanam. Atra pullingam, prathamavibhaktihi, dvivachanam. ओंकारः च अथ शब्दः च एतौ द्वौ। एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ ओम एंड द वर्ड अथ, दीज टू। पुरा इज कॉमन एडवर्ब फॉर बोथ भित्वा एंड विनिर्यातौ। पुरा अव्ययम् इन ओल्डन टाइम्स। ब्रह्मणः कंठम इज कर्मपद विभागः ऑफ भित्वा। ब्रह्मणः ब्रह्मन् पुल्लिंगम अथवा नपुसकलिंगम। अत्र पुल्लिंगम तस्य षष्ठ्येकवचनम्। कंठम कंठ थ्रोट पुल्लिंगम तस्य द्वितीयैकवचनम्। भित्वा भिद् इति धातुः प्रथमगणीयः परस्मैपदी अथवा सप्तमगणीयः उभयपदी अपि। टू ब्रेक थ्रू तस्य क्त्वा कृदन्तम्। विनिर्यातौ वि प्लस निर् प्लस या द्वितीयगणीयः परस्मैपदी। टु एमर्ज तस्य क्तकृदन्तं विनिर्यात तस्य पुल्लिङ्गं प्रथमाविभक्तिः द्विवचनं विनिर्यातौ। ओंकारः च अथ शब्दः च एतौ द्वौ पुरा ब्रह्मणः कंठं भित्वा विनिर्यातौ। एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ ओम एंड दि वर्ड अथ, दीज टू, long time ago emerged on breaking through the throat of Brahman. Tasmat ubhau mangalikau. Tasmat tat sarvanama pullingam napusakalingam tasya panchamyekavachanam. Literally, tasmat means from that. It is also used adverbially as hence. Ubhau, ubha, pronoun adjective. Both pullingam, ubha means both. Pullingam prathamadvivachanam, used only in the dual, so hence always dvivachanam. Mangalikau, mangalika, visheshanam, auspicious. Atra pullingam prathamavibhaktihi dvivachanam. Tasmat ubhau mangalikau, hence both are considered auspicious. Note, are considered is the verbal words, verb-related words, which I have added because they are not there in the original text. Chhando Vishleshanam, metrical analysis. Omkarashchathashabdashcha, ashtaksharani. Panchamashashtasaptamani, thashabdashcha. Because of cha, bdha becomes with two matras. Tesham matraha, eka, dve, dve. Dvavetau brahmanah pura, ashtaksharani. Panchamashashtasaptamani, mhanah pu. Tesham matraha, eka, dve, eka. Kantham bhitva viniryatau, ashtaksharani. Panchamashashtasaptamani, vinirya. Tesham matraha, eka, dve, dve. Tasman mangalika vubhau, ashtaksharani. Panchamashashtasaptamani, li, ka, vu. Tesham matraha, eka, dve, eka. Anushtap chandaha. Tippanyaha, notes. In anvayaha, shabdabhyasascha, Brahman is detailed at 1-D-1 as both pullingam or napusakalingam. In the present context, I have taken it as pullingam because the phrase we have is brahmana kantham. Note, only Brahman pullingam would have kantha. In Apte's dictionary, there is interesting detail for Brahman, both pullingam and napusakalingam. Brahman, masculine, pullingam, the supreme being, the creator, the first deity of the sacred Hindu trinity, to whom is entrusted the work of creating the world. The accounts of the creation of the world differ in many respects. But according to Manusmriti, the universe was enveloped in darkness and the self-existent Lord manifested himself dispelling the gloom. He first created the waters and deposited in them a seed. This seed became a golden egg in which he himself was born as Brahma, the progenitor of all the worlds. Then the Lord divided the egg into two parts, with which he constructed heaven and earth. He then created the 10 Prajapatis or mind-born sons who completed the work of creation. According to another account, Ramayana, Brahma sprang from ether. From him was descended Marichi, and his son was Kashyapa. From Kashyapa sprang Vivaswata, and Manu sprang from him. This Manu was the procreator of all human beings. According to a third account, the supreme deity, after dividing the golden egg, separated himself into two parts, male and female, from which sprang Viraja and from him Manu. Mythologically, Brahman is represented as being born in a lotus which sprang from the navel of Vishnu and as creating the world by an illicit connection with his own daughter Saraswati. Brahman had originally 5 heads, but one of them was cut down by Shiva with the ring finger or burned down by the fire from his third eye. His vehicle is a swan. He has numerous epithets, most of which have reference to his birth in a lotus. Brahman Napusakalingam, the supreme being, regarded as impersonal and divested of all quality and action. According to the Vedantins, Brahman is both the efficient and the material cause of the visible universe, the all-pervading soul and spirit of the universe, the essence from which all created things are produced and into which they are absorbed. Thinking of Brahmanah Kantham Bhitva Viniryato, I am left wondering what made the two so eager that they broke through the throat of Brahman. Of course, that the two so emerged by breaking through the throat of Brahman is all basically the poet's imagination. It is all figurative. It certainly creates a figure of how the event would have occurred. What figure of speech is this? Chitrakavyam? One can associate one reason for their eagerness. that the time scale of Brahman is too long. In Gita, it is said, Sahasra Yuga Paryantam Aharyat Brahmano Viduhu Ratrim Yuga Sahasranam Teho Ratra Vidho Janaha. Translation by Swami Gambhirananda from this URL of Gita Supersite is, those people who are knowers of what day and night are, know the day of Brahma, which ends in 1,000 yugas, the 4 yugas in the human worlds, namely Satya, Treta, Dwapara and Kali, are made up of 4,320,000 years. This period multiplied by 1,000 constitutes one day of Brahma. His night also extends over an equal period. But because in that period, one set of yugas is a set of 4, I think the multiplication should be theoretically by 250 and not by 1,000. Anyway, I am just thinking of the logic that Omkara hacha atha shabda hacha etau dvau are auspicious ubhau mangalikau because both emerge on breaking through the throat of Brahman. The logic seems to be that Brahmanaha kantha, throat of Brahman, is auspicious and anything emerging from it is auspicious. In turn, the positive thought conveyed by the Subhashitam is that if we keep our mind mangalam, whatever thought will emerge therein or therefrom will also be mangalam. Whatever project is undertaken, first invoking the sacred Om and or Atha will be blessed with mangalyam. Keeping mind niramayam and filled and blessed with mangalyam will require training the mind to start every project after first invoking the sacred Om and or Atha. This can be helped also by Omkara Dhyanam. Adhiyama Subhashitani Sanskritanshya Subhamas.